200 Jewish children and their caretakers who refused to leave their charges from here. Children under the age of three were shot in an unknown location, and the remainder of the caretakers were deported to Belzec death camp and murdered there. Shocking. Awful.
It's like a memorial.
Yeah. Yeah, see, there is no big one back here. It's mad, isn't it? This was in Britain.
So, play an empty field, and during World War II, a place full of wooden barracks, where were housed hundreds of prisoners.
It's amazing to think that that's the original house. And this is all the camp.
Okay, so now you choose. We can go up over here to avoid the mud, or if you would like to see those remnants of the Jewish gravestones that were destroyed by the Germans in 1940 during the war, they are just over there, more or less in front of us. We can see at least some stones. Those are remnants. Yeah.
So they built barracks on there.
Here.
Yeah. And this was the field there.
Yeah, on the left hand side, and more or less over you can see all those trees, the Jewish sector.
Oh, wow.
Always wooden barracks.
They're cheaper. Aren't they? Quicker to build.
Jewish cemetery. One gravestone wasn't destroyed. Why? We don't have any idea. Just
stones on top, like she was saying.
Yeah.
A Polish Jew who was buried over here in 1932, so before the outbreak of World War II. Documents safe haven for them because they were outside the horror that they so evidently they turned in the camp. So in 1943, in summer 1943, the Jews were relocated from this camp to some barracks situated straight next to the fire.
All the barracks are right across this field.
Yeah.
And there's the grey house down at the bottom.
And
that's
the abandoned.
Commandant's villa would be there where you can see those private houses.
Mm.
So as you can see from there, it would be impossible to shoot prisoners that were over here. Also those that
massive
things